On vanilla PC Terraria, the Mythical Vilethorn does 11 damage, a base damage of 10, plus a 10% boost. However, on tMod Loader, and indeed any other version of Terraria, the Mythical Vilethorn deals 12 damage, a base damage of 10, plus a 20% boost. Huh. What's happening behind the hood here is that Mythical grants a plus 15% damage boost, which, for a base damage of 10, would mean a boosted damage value of 11.5. However, since weapons can only have integer damage values, it has to be rounded to the nearest integer. In this case, 11.5 should round to 12, the nearest integer, but as you can see, sometimes it doesn't. So why does this happen? Well, it has a little to do with how computers store numbers. Let's start with something simple. Many of you are probably already familiar with how computers store whole numbers. Essentially, it's just the same as our decimal base 10 system, but in binary base 2. Just like how 143 is written as 1 times 100 plus 4 times 10 plus 3 times 1 in decimal base 10, 143 is written as 1 times 128 plus 1 times 8 plus 1 times 4 plus 1 times 2 plus 1 times 1 in base 2 binary. But what about numbers that aren't whole numbers, like, let's say, 1.5? Well, it's actually just the same, extended past the decimal point. We write parts of whole numbers the same way we write multiples of them. When we write 2.875, we really mean 2 times 1 plus 8 times 0.1 plus 7 times 0.01 plus 5 times 0.001. In binary, it's the same. It's 2 times 1 plus 1 times 0.5 plus 1 times 0.25 plus 1 times 0.125. The same, just in different base. Looking at this, you can see that just like the decimal base 10 system we learned in school, binary base 2 could represent numbers just the same. Two ways to represent the same numeric concept. However, sometimes there's an issue. Now, for whole numbers or integers, there's no problem. You can easily write any integer or whole number in either decimal or binary, but for non-integers, it gets complicated. Take 0.3. In decimal, we can easily write this out. However, it is quite literally impossible for 0.3 to be written in binary. You can get really close, and it can get more and more precise the more bits you add, but you can never get there. If you've ever done 0.1 plus 0.2 in Python and got 0.300 blah 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 4, now you know why. It's kinda like how 1/3 is really easy to write in base 3, but impossible to write in decimal. No matter how many 3s you append to the end, you can't quite represent it in decimal. You can get more precise, but you can never represent it perfectly. Just like how some numbers, like 1/3 in base 3, are easy to represent in some bases, but impossible to represent in decimal, some easy decimal numbers, like 0.1, actually are impossible to write in those other bases, like binary. Now, the standard for encoding non-whole, also known as floating point numbers, IEEE 754, is actually a little more complicated than what I just explained, but the effect is the same. Sometimes, floating point numbers from one base just can't be precisely written in another. Okay, so what does this have to do with our Mythical Vilethorn and the rounding error? Well, the imprecision. You see, Mythical grants a 15% damage boost, which is multiplying the base damage by 1.15. However, it is impossible to write 1.15 in binary precisely. Using a standard single precision floating point number, which is what Terraria uses, the best we can actually do is 1.14999761581420898437. When Terraria multiplies 10, the base damage of the Vilethorn, by the number 1.15, which is actually 1.14999976 blah blah blah, it gets a number slightly less than 11.5, and thus rounds down to 11, instead of computing to 11.5 and correctly rounding to 12. That's why the Mythical Vilethorn does 11 damage in Terraria instead of 12. This actually isn't the only example of this in Terraria. A legendary copper pickaxe has a use time of 13, not 14, because 0.9 can't be represented accurately and thus rounds down. A ruthless megashark has a damage of 29, not 30, because 1.18 can't be represented accurately and thus rounds down. And a damaged Vilethorn has a damage of 9, not 8, because 0.85 can't be represented accurately and thus rounds incorrectly. So that's why vanilla PC Terraria sometimes has rounding errors. But why don't tMod and the other systems have the same rounding errors? Doesn't it do the same thing? Well, here's where it gets complicated. It's not that tMod and the others are immune to imprecision errors. That's just a fact of computing, you can't get rid of it. However, computers are generally able to compensate for that a bit. For example, if you code a small C# program to multiply 10 and 1.15, you will actually get 11.5. This is because the error is small enough that it gets eliminated when the multiplication actually occurs. Thus, you get 11.5, and it rounds correctly to 12. Now, some floating point errors are simply big enough that they aren't eliminated in multiplication. The Ruthless Megashark rounds to 29 instead of 30 on all platforms, for example, but generally, most errors are eliminated. The actual in-depth reason why vanilla PC Terraria has so many rounding errors is because it handles floating point multiplication a little differently than normal. That's to say that tMod's fewer errors is the norm, and vanilla PC Terraria is just specifically error-prone. Vanilla PC runs on a different, older framework than other versions, even tMod Loader, and this framework does floating point multiplication slightly differently. Specifically, it uses a specific instruction, which interacts with a specific unit, which converts the 32-bit float to a more precise 80-bit float when multiplying, and this precision preserves the error during the operation so it isn't corrected or rounded off. Or at least that's what I think it is. I'm no systems designer. Meanwhile, tMod, and presumably the other versions, use standard floating point multiplication where no extra precision is added, so the error isn't preserved more than it normally is. Basically, vanilla PC deals with multiplication with extra precision, which preserves the error in a way normal floating point multiplication, used by other platforms, does not. And thus, more floating point errors, and thus rounding errors, present themselves in vanilla PC. Alright, now that we know all this, how could we theoretically fix this? Well, the easiest option is to store modifier values as integers, and then divide later. For example, instead of storing 1.15 as a float, you can store 115 as an integer, which has no intrinsic error. Then once you multiply damage and the modifier as two integers, which also has no error, you can then divide by 100 to get our final answer. Since binary can represent halves perfectly, this division will leave behind no error, and everything is hunky-dory. Since all modifiers in Terraria work by percents, this is a quite simple and intuitive solution to the problem. Just multiply by 100, and let the integers do the work. So, that's floating point imprecision in Terraria. It's quite a strange bug, because it's caused by no fault of the programmer, but instead by the system it's running on. It was certainly a brain teaser to find, analyze, and explain this. Speaking of which, a massive thank you to Kellam Yoshikage, also known as Amaboye, and Alatheron for finding and analyzing this bug. This video couldn't have been made without them, especially the bits dealing with the lower level parts of the system. That's the stuff I have very, very little experience with. Anyway, if you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing as it supports the channel, as only about a third of you all are. Similar videos should be on the left and right. Either way though, thank you for watching, and good day, and goodbye. See you next Fortnite.